Home row modifiers are a great way to improve your workflow and comfort when using the keyboard. The idea is simple. Move Ctrl, Win or Command, Alt, and Shift to the home row, where your fingers naturally rest. That way, you don't need to move your hand or contort your fingers when capitalizing letters or activating shortcuts, which is pretty painful. You press modifiers with one hand and the key you want to modify with the opposite hand. Looks promising, right? Let's see how to configure them on your keyboard. Home row modifiers use a feature of programmable keyboards that allows you to configure a key that behaves as a letter when you tap it and a modifier when you hold it. This feature is called Tap Hold on Q and K, while on the Digma keyboards it's called Super Keys. Start by setting those keys up. Open Basecore and press Configure on your keyboard. Go to the Super Keys editor and create a new Super Key. Let's start by creating the Super F. First, assign F to Tap. Then press Hold and select the modifier you want to assign. In this case, let's choose Shift. Repeat this for the rest of the keys that you want to configure. Press Save Changes and head over to the Layout Editor. Finally, you only need to assign the super keys to their corresponding keys. Press Save Changes again and you're done. As you can see, I have set up my modifiers to be Option, Alt, Command and Shift for ASDF and the opposite to JKL semicolon. So, Shift, Command, Alt, and Control. The equivalent configuration on Windows is Win, Alt, Control, and Shift. This disposition allows you to trigger the most shortcuts with one hand and reduces the number of accidental capitalizations when rolling your keys. More on that later. Of course, there are other ways to arrange the modifiers, each with pros and cons. For example, Shift, Control, Win, Alt is the easiest to learn, as the modifiers are placed similarly to how you are used to. Shift, Control, Win, Alt. However, you use your weakest fingers, pinky and ring, for Shift and Control. Win, Alt, Shift, Control is one of the most popular. You use your middle and index fingers for Shift and Control, and with Shift in the middle, you can easily press Shift-Control or Shift-Alt. If you're on Mac, you should swap Control for Command. Okay, so everything is set up. But how does the keyboard know when you want to type a letter or trigger a modifier? When is Tap a Tap and Hold a Hold? We mentioned that the keyboard will output the letter on Tap and the modifier on Hold. But how long do you have to hold a key to become a hold? What if I'm a slow typist and keep my fingers on the key for too long? Let's see how you can fine-tune your home row modifiers to adapt them to your typing style and preferences. If you open the Preferences menu on Basecore, you'll see different settings for super keys. Hold timeout, overlap threshold, minimum hold time, minimum prior interval, and next tap timeout. This last one only affects super keys with keys configured beyond hold. So for the purpose of home row modifiers, we can ignore it. If you want to know more about super keys, check out this other video. Hold timeout is the amount of time you need to hold for hold to be activated. A high value means the whole function will take more time to activate. The default is 250 milliseconds. However, this setting only applies if you're pressing this key exclusively. Pressing another key at the same time will immediately trigger the hold function, aka you'll activate the modifier. Pressing Fi will trigger Shift-I. This behavior is great for triggering shortcuts and capitalizing letters quickly, but it can also cause misactivations. Most of us roll our keys while typing. That means we press the following key before fully releasing the previous one, just like this. If you do that with a home row modifier, you'll get plenty of those missed triggers. And you really don't want to trigger Ctrl W, close tab, when you were trying to type W. That's where the rest of the settings come in. Overlap threshold lets you roll your keys without triggering the hold function. That means that pressing another key won't immediately trigger the hold function. There is some leeway to release the previous key. I can do this, and it won't trigger the modifiers. But if I do this, the computer complains because I trigger control or something like that. The higher the number, the bigger the leeway. Increase this setting if you're accidentally activating the modifier. Lower it if you're not getting it when you want. The default value is 80. But if you're going to use Homebrew modifiers, I recommend setting this to 100. The minimum hold time prevents hold from activating under any circumstance unless the set time has elapsed. It's like an additional safeguard in case the overlap threshold set to 100 is not enough. Increase this if you accidentally trigger the modifiers. Lower it if you don't trigger them when you want. The default value is 50, but for Homebrew modifiers, we recommend at least 80 or 100. Minimum prior interval measures the time elapsed between the previous key press and the key that has the modifier. So, if I'm going to press V and then F, which has the modifier, it measures the time between I press V and then F. If it's lower than the time set, the hold function won't trigger. So, if I press V and then F super fast, hold will not activate. This is useful because we usually pause for a split second before intentionally pressing a modifier, so the time elapsed is higher than when we type normally. Increase this if you accidentally trigger the modifiers. Lower it if you don't trigger them when you want to. If you're interested in the logic behind the behavior of Homebrew modifiers, I've left a link to a flowchart in the description below. These settings apply to all superkeys with a modifier or a layer on hold. Today, we've seen it applied for Homebrew modifiers, but this can be useful for many things, like creating an arrow cluster where you have arrows on tap and modifiers on hold, but also to get the most out of your thumbkeys. Here are a few videos to help you explore all the different possibilities. And don't forget to share your experience with Homebrew modifiers in the comments. I feel like Morfeo, you can choose the red pill or the blue pill.